Today we will be discussing about scales in fishes. The scales of fishes are of dermal origin, that means they originate from the dermis layer of the skin, while the scales of other animals are usually of epidermal origin, that means they originate from the epidermis layer of the skin. The scales of fishes are small, thin, cornified, calcareous or bony plates closely fitted together or overlap each other. The scales of fishes vary in shape and size in different species of fish. The scales are present all over the body, but in some fishes these are present in localized areas only. There are 5 types of scales present in fishes, that is cosmoid, plecoid, ganoid, which are also known as rhomboidal scales, cycloid scales and tenoid scales. The first type of scales are cosmoid scales. These are absent in living fishes and were present in some ostracoderms, placoderms and sarcopterygians. These consist of 4 layers, as you can see in the picture. First layer is ganoid layer, second layer is cosmoid layer, third layer is spongy bone and fourth is compact bone. This picture shows the arrangement of cosmoid scale in fishes. Next type of scales are plecoid scales. These are characteristics of cartilaginous fishes. These consist of backwardly directed spines arising from the round or rhomboid basal plate embedded in dermis. As you can see in the picture, the scale consists of a spine and a bottom basal plate. The spine is made of enamel-like and the basal plate is made of dentine-like material, as are present in teeth of human beings. A pulp cavity inside the spine opens through the basal plate. These are closely placed and give sandpaper-like appearance, as you can see in this picture. The next type of scales are ganoid scales, which are also known as rhomboidal scales. These are thick rhomboid or diamond-shaped plates closely fitted like tiles and in some cases overlap. These are characteristics of chondrosteans like Polypterus and Accipenser and holosteans like Lepidosteans. So they are also called ganoid fishes. The ganoid scales are further of 2 types, that is paleoniscoid as in Polypterus and other is Lepidosteoid as is Lepidosteus. The difference is that the first type of scale consists of 3 layers, while the Lepidosteoid scales consist of 2 layers. This picture shows the arrangement of ganoid scale over the skin of fishes. As you can see, these appear like tiles present on the floor. Next type of scale are cycloid scales. These are thin, flexible, translucent plates, circular in outline, thicker in center, and marked with several concentric lines of growth. These lines determine the age of the fish. As you can see in the picture, the central circular part of the line is known as nucleus, from where other circular lines originate. The cycloid scales are composed of thin upper layer of bone and lower of fibrous connective tissue. Each scale is embedded in small pocket of dermis and overlap each other. These are found in lungfishes, dipnoans, some holosteans and lower teleosteans like carps and coads. This picture shows the arrangement of cycloid scales over the body of fishes. The last type of scales are tenoid scales. These are very much similar in outline to the cycloid scales. The only difference is that they bear teeth-like processes on their outline. These are characteristics of modern teleosteans like perches. They are similar to cycloid scales in structure and arrangement. These are more firmly attached and exposed free ends are not overlapped and bear numerous small comb-like teeth or spines. Some fishes bear both tenoid and cycloid scales like flounders. This picture is showing the arrangement of tenoid scale over the body of fishes. Thank you so much.